In this example, we calculate the concentration of an unknown diprotic acid based on experimental titration data. Our problem reads, the titration of 12.4 milliliters of an unknown diprotic acid requires 19.1 milliliters of 0.104 molar sodium hydroxide solution to reach the equivalence point. What is the concentration of the unknown acid sample? First, we need a balanced chemical equation for the acid-base reaction. We don't know what diprotic acid we're titrating, but what's important is that a diprotic acid has two hydrogen atoms that can be removed. We can represent the diprotic acid as H2A, where A is a generic anion with a 2- charge. In an acid-base neutralization reaction, an acid and a base react to produce water and a salt. The salt will be Na2A. We know sodium has a 1+ charge, and the anion A has a 2- charge, so we need 2 sodium for every 1 A anion in the formula unit. Now let's balance. In the acid-base reaction, 1 H+ from the acid reacts with 1 hydroxide from the base to produce 1 water. In this reaction, we have 2 H+ ions from the acid because it's diprotic. So we need 2 hydroxide, and we will produce 2 water molecules. This reaction should now be balanced. We want to calculate molarity of the acid. The equation for molarity is moles of solute divided by liters of solution. To find moles of H2A, we can use dimensional analysis to convert our volume of sodium hydroxide solution to moles of H2A. First, let's convert from milliliters to liters. Then we can use the molarity of sodium hydroxide to convert from liters sodium hydroxide solution to moles of sodium hydroxide. Then we can convert from moles of sodium hydroxide to moles of H2A using the coefficients in the balanced chemical equation. We need 2 moles of NaOH for every 1 mole of H2A. Completing the calculation, we have 9.93 times 10 to the negative 4th moles of H2A. We can substitute this into our equation for molarity. Moles of H2A goes in the numerator, and liters of H2A solution goes in the denominator. We convert our 12.4 milliliters of H2A solution into liters before plugging it into this equation. Completing our molarity calculation, we should get 0.0801 molar H2A.